Hello students, welcome once again. Today we begin new chapter of civics, chapter number 2, the Indian Parliament. Dear students, in previous chapter already we learned how the parliament plays an important role in parliamentary system of government. In this chapter we will discuss the Parliament of India. See, this is the image of Parliament House, New Delhi. So let's see about Parliament. The students, what is Parliament? The legislature at the national level, that is the level of the central government, is called Parliament. It consists of President and the two houses of Parliament, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Dear students, here Parliament consists of the President, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Though President is an inseparable part of the Parliament, he or she cannot participate in the discussions of the houses of the Parliament. Dear students, we know that President is not separate part of the Parliament, but he or she cannot participate in the discussions of the houses of the Parliament. The two houses of the Parliament are called the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. It means Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, these are the two houses of the Parliament. Now let's see about Lok Sabha. The Lok Sabha is the lower and the first house of the Parliament of India. Lok Sabha is the house of representatives directly elected by the people. Dear students, here Lok Sabha, it is the house which is directly, representatives are directly elected by the people. So this is called the first house. The members of Lok Sabha are elected directly by people from the territorial constituencies. The tenure of Lok Sabha is 5 years, means the working period of the Lok Sabha is 5 years. The elections take place after every 5 years. These elections are also known as general elections. Dear students, the elections which are take place after 5 years, the elections which are take place after every 5 years are known as general elections. However, there are examples when the Lok Sabha was dissolved before the completion of the 5 years. Elections held in such a case are called midterm elections. Midterm elections means the elections which is held when Lok Sabha was dissolved before the completion of 5 years. My dear student, dissolved means destroyed. See here, the elections held in such a case means when the Lok Sabha was dissolved before the completion of the 5 years, and in such a case elections are held, and these are called midterm elections. Lok Sabha is the representative body of the citizen of the country. As per the constitution, there can be a maximum of 552 members in the Lok Sabha. Dear students, there are maximum members. How many? 552 members in the Lok Sabha. To ensure representations to all sections of the society, some seats are reserved for members belonging to scheduled caste and scheduled tribe. See, dear students, here the word Marathi word Arakshan, it means reserve. Seats are reserved for the members who are belonging to scheduled caste and scheduled tribe. In case there are no representatives from the Anglo-Indian community, the president can appoint 2 members from this community to the Lok Sabha. Dear students, if in case there are no representatives from the Anglo-Indian community, the president appoint 2 members from this community to the Lok Sabha. Now we are going to learn about Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha, the upper and the second house of parliament, is the Rajya Sabha. This is the upper house and second house is known as Rajya Sabha, whereas the lower house and the first house is called Lok Sabha. The members of Rajya Sabha are indirectly elected. The Rajya Sabha gives representation of 29 states and 7 union territories in India. Dear students, here these are 29 states and here these are the 7 union territories in India. Thus, members of Rajya Sabha work as representatives of the constituent states. The total membership of Rajya Sabha is 250 members. Amongst them, 238 members are elected from the constituent states and union territories. All the constituent states do not get equal representation in the Rajya Sabha. It is proportionate to the total population of each of the state. Remaining 12 members are appointed by the president. These members are usually experienced and distinguished personalities. Dear students, the 12 members who were appointed by the president, they are most well experienced and distinguished personalities. They are from the fields of literature, See, dear students, the 12 members who are appointed by the president from the field of literature, arts, sports, science, and social work. The members of Rajya Sabha are elected through the system of proportional representation. Rajya Sabha is never dissolved completely, hence it is called a permanent house. Dear students, here Rajya Sabha is never destroyed completely, so it is called a permanent house. 1/3 members of total members of Rajya Sabha who have completed their tenure of 6 years retire after every 2 years, and equal number of new members get elected. Because the limited members of Rajya Sabha retire step by step, Rajya Sabha can function continuously. Any person contesting for the elections of Rajya Sabha must be an Indian citizen and he must have completed 30 years of age. Dear students, the person who want to contest for the elections of Rajya Sabha, he or she must be an Indian citizen and he or she must have completed 30 years of age. Members of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha are known as members of Parliament, means MPS, means members of Parliament. Members of Parliament try to resolve the queries and complaints of their constituencies by raising questions in the Parliament. Government allocates them funds to carry out development activities or the work in their respective constituencies. Dear students, remaining part of this chapter, that is functions of the Parliament, formulations of laws, we will learn in our next video. So, dear students, read the lesson carefully, is today's assignment. Thank you and have a nice day.